Good evening. This is the bells and whistles session of our Push for Pathways program. That was a lot of P's. So we've gone over the introductory elements of Pathways. We've gone over a question and answers session. Now this time, I and Jason Cook will go through the little extras, all the little things that you don't really need in Pathways, but they're there for your use if you are so inclined. So I'm going to get right into Pathways here. So let's just start from the top. If you click on your profile, it can take you to the Basecamp profile. You can put in a little summary about yourself. You can put in interest tags just by clicking this little pencil here that's next to it off on the far right. So if you wanted to edit your summary, it has a little what you see is what you get editor here. Fairly straightforward. You can click cancel to get out of it. If you don't want to save your changes, click save. Hello. Save. And this you might add interests however you like. So training, I hit enter and that saves. Let's see what happens if we try to save a two word. Self-mastery. Ah, so yep, just hitting enter and proceeding.
Hey, Nick, with these interests, other than just being something you could use for self-reference, is there any way that this is made visible to anyone else? I don't know that it is, but is it just kind of organization?
It is made visible to your fellow club members.
Okay.
So, in fact, we'll go over that soon, but you can save. Elsewhere, you can put these dates in. There's not a way to track all the times that I've been in all counter in Pathways. You can only put one date per role. So I just populated it with the first time I ever did that role. If you are so inclined, you could come in here every time you do it and update this to the latest time you did it. That's your prerogative. These are some of the things you can change. This is also where you can change your profile picture. Actually, strike that. It's elsewhere. It's under settings in my account. So up here on the gear or cog, I just hover over it and it pops this menu out. If you go to my account, this is where you can edit your profile picture, change or delete your image. Change will ask you to choose a file, and you can resize, crop. I'm going to cancel because I liked it the way it was. You can specify your time zone and signature. This is where you can put in the dates that you did these roles. And save or cancel. Any questions so far? Kind of straightforward. So that where you can look others up, I didn't even have to hit enter, it just pulls up a list.
That's people in your club, right?
Yes, yep, it's people in my club. See, Harp with you, Toastmasters. If I wanted to look up Brad Vandermolen, nothing, not a thing. Jason Cook, nothing. Let's see. Bob Lewis, he's a member. It does show officers, right? So
Hey, if you're a member of more than one club, and I'm not, but I don't know if you are, or some of us on this call might be, I assume it would pull up all the names of people of the clubs that you're a member of, perhaps?
I'm not sure. I believe it has to do with which clubs you associate to which pathways.
Okay.
I don't have any. I might have to join a second club just so I can learn more about that. And
not that critical. I've never done it myself, so I wouldn't dare it. Suggest you should.
But I do know that there's nuances and difficulty for people who are duly enrolled. The other thing, so look, as me looking at another member of my club, I can see what they filled in for their email, their summary and their interests, as well as when they filled various roles. The other things that I can do, look at feedback and e-portfolio. This is something of interest. There was a lot of misconceptions about pathways early on, and the thinking was that you could upload your evaluation materials, you know, completed evaluations to your e-portfolio, and then your VPE could refer to those to see that you've completed different projects. If I go to Dory's e-portfolio, I can't see her documents. It'll always show as zero for me, even if I'm logged in as Basecamp manager. Her documents, whatever she's put into her e-portfolio, is private to her. I can, however, see badges. So Dory's been very active. I can do some filtering here for just the learning badges, which these are the ones that are pathways specific. When she's completed a pathway, it'll say that she's proficient in that pathway. And for each level, there's a badge received. It's not specific to a pathway, so it just puts a little number next to it when level 5 is achieved twice. You can also see that when a pathway is activated here. This can be useful for vice presidents of education. Maybe they want to go back and order badges physically and have them mailed or sent to the member. And there's also feedback, where there's ways that members can send badges to one another. And we'll get into that shortly. One of the reasons I think this feature is not often used by members or discussed is because there's no notification sent to the member when they get a badge. There's not an email, text message, nothing that shows up in their Toastmasters.org profile that doesn't even like put a little dot up on their profile saying they have notifications. It's just there to go in and see if there's anything new.
Is it awarded automatically based on their progress and pathway or what have you?
The learning ones are.
Yeah.
So these badges are received automatically for progressing in pathways.
Level 4, level 3. Okay. That
makes and sense. The feedback ones are sent by members to members.
Okay.
So if I just go to the feedback tab, right before what I was on was ePortfolio, and I went to badges from there. But if I go to this feedback tab, again, I'm still on a fellow member. I can see the feedback she's received from members. I can also share feedback with her and make it either visible to everyone or visible to just her. I'll be honest, I'm not sure who Dory's managers are. I'm going to assume that's at least the VPE, perhaps also club officers. But this may take some experimentation. So if I wanted to send private feedback, I can type my message. Thank you for being and I have options. I can add an attachment. That's what this paperclip means. Notice though that I'm kind of locked in. If I select a file, I'll just choose some random image. I think I chose a large image. Yeah, but now I can't choose a badge. So I will post. So basically uploading an attachment is kind of like making your own custom badge. So put this here and I choose badge. This is where I can pick some of the member to member specific badges, right? So I could say courageous and gave your fifth icebreaker so brave.
So you could send a badge, but could you attach the evaluation and send it through this system?
I believe so.
I understand you can't see the document somebody else has. I was just kind of
let's give that a try.
Yeah, I see the paperclip there. I assume that you can.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it may just be image files though.
Okay.
Let's see. Toastmasters. The file name is too long. Okay.
You're just super organized, Nick. That's what the problem is.
There we go. So yeah, okay. you can do PDFs. Nice. You can do images. I'm sure there's some kind of file extension constraints. I just don't know what they are.
Okay.
I haven't tried to break it. But here you can see. Wait, I thought. Yeah. So down here we can see an inspirational badge from another member, not from me, to Dory, and I can see his comments, and I could put in, I totally agree, Brian, and Brian will never know I did this, because nor will Dory, because no notifications are sent.
So that would be a major improvement they could make if they would notify you of mm-hmm. badges and other things sent to your e-portfolio, right?
Right.
Or feedback in this case, but I shouldn't have gotten confused. E-portfolio is really specific and private, but the feedback can be something they could use a notification for when it's sent. Okay.
And this is something new. So now I'm still looking at Dory's. If I go to mine, notice when I'm logged in as me and I'm on my profile, I have the tab for paths and learning, so I could jump to my paths here. And my e-portfolio, I've got badges and documents. I can see my documents. Come into feedback. I can see the feedback I've received.
Hey, Nadia.
So here's one where I was trying out way back when what requesting feedback. So if I'm on my page and on the feedback section, here I can enter in a request for feedback.
Yeah. I've never really used that feedback portal there, but I'm beginning to see I need to learn to use it. Really, it's pretty handy.
Right. And apparently I've just found this too. So on feedback, these ellipses over here, this is where you can see others' requests of you. So if I view all feedback requests I can see that Ed Zinkowitz, a member, another member of Harpeth View, requested feedback way back on. I'm just now seeing it.
Yeah, you're finding it, right?
That's great. 2 years old today.
this is so much taking me back. This is so much taking me into eBay. I do a lot of eBay stuff. That feedback, man, I love it. This is great. Pathways to best of both worlds.
So to interact with this feedback request, I would need to click the link, the URL part that requested. And now I could and there we go. I bet if I were to go to his profile, I see he's filled it out, his summary, and he has tabs. But it doesn't even give, maybe if I go to feedback. Yeah, so here's his, has requested feedback from two people, you know, Dory and myself, and the comment I just made showing here. Again, no notifications, no emails. And this again takes me to his About Me page. I think, yeah, so here is the Basecamp manager. So every club has one extra member in Pathways, and that's the Basecamp manager. It's technically another user within the system. And the user first name is club, last name is your club number. And if you want to know this, if you want to know what emails go, let me say this correctly. When somebody submits for approval of completing their path, it'll go to the Basecamp manager email. You can't change this here, but it's, you can still reference it here. You can see it here. You could click it and it'll open up a mail to link and you could send an email to it.
Which officers in the club typically have Basecamp manager rights?
It's up to the club. The way you change this, officers can set it back at toastmasters.org and under leadership, club central, and it is club contact and meeting information, email. In our case, we have this email go to club president, VPE, and VPM. Usually, you know, if somebody's trying to club contact, well, you know, we want the VPM, as in vice president membership, to receive it and see it and respond, because it's kind of like a inside sales opportunity, right? This is someone clearly interested in our club. It's not really a job for the VP of PR, which is to reel them in. And then club president to keep them aware. And VPE is necessary, in my opinion, since Pathways approval requests go to this email as well. So we have some kind of forwarding set up so that any emails sent to this email address get auto redirected to those three personal email addresses. However you want to manage yourselves as a club, but that's what we do. Let's see. So there's the.
Why does it say that it filled a role in a meeting?
I don't know. it was some time ago, right? All of these. I'm going to guess that my predecessor as VPE put these in, maybe for himself or herself, not realizing that they were logged in as a Basecamp manager.
Now, here's my question, Nick, and this is maybe too much, but as you may be aware, my VPE has left the company. So then the question becomes, yes, she'll still be Toastmaster, but if her work email becomes inactive, who's going to be approving the VPE request?
Well, you're going to want to change the email. When you go in, let's see. I'll come out and go in as Basecamp manager. The club president can log in as Basecamp manager, and I believe it's the secretary who can log in as Basecamp manager.
Maybe and, I can. Okay, wait, because no, now you're making me wonder. I know when I was secretary, I used to be able to.
Yeah, and it's tied to the officer role. So, I mean, if you can get into Club Central, then
okay,
that's a good, there's a good chance, but not guaranteed. I'm pretty sure it does look at this, you know, this list of your club officer assignments. So
president, yeah, by default, they sent it out as presidents, VPEs and secretaries have Basecamp right managed.
Right. And that's necessary if there needs to be at least one backup, right? Because a VPE, it'll detect. If I log in to Basecamp manager and I, as a member, have submitted an educational progression request, I can't approve it. I can't approve my own requests for approval. So I would need to convince the president or the secretary to go in and do it for me. That or wait until I'm not VPE anymore and then do it.
Okay. I'm going to have to email.
Those three officers is because that you are a council member when the members of the club start voting for the leadership roles at conferences, for example.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, even if you don't get those notifications that someone is, you know, has a pending approval that they've submitted for approval, you can still log in as Basecamp manager and click pending requests and see them listed. And when I say you can, I'm assuming you're either club president, VPE, or secretary.
Yeah, my club's gonna, I want to throw my club members out the door. Because the board members specifically, I brought this up 2 weeks ago. We're gonna have a missing VPE. Oh, good point. And well, now she's not in the company anymore. And wow, look at that, VPE role is still empty. And I'm like, okay, I'm gonna be submitting level five at the end of, I'm gonna be submitting level five for innovative planning by next month. And I mean, literally, this club, HCA Artful Articulators, is going to be the only club, and I'm area director, is going to be the only club that's distinguished. So, yeah, just area director problems.
Sure. Yeah, I'm happy to maybe help with that outside of this. There are ways you can archive things you've completed so you can take them off the list, so to speak. I'm looking at this past. Okay, so I'm logged in as Basecamp manager now. That's what threw me. And I'm drilling into this because I'm a little perplexed why this is showing up. Oh, right. Okay. This I was doing some research to get project descriptions for different things and see what the Basecamp manager can do. And that's showing in this history. So if I wanted to clean this up, I can just go in and move these to archive. All it does is moves it to another list, like an automatically or a hidden list that's hidden by default. And now there's one less thing in my list. And if I want to see it, I can just change my filter here from active items to archived items.
Hey, Nick, the part about, I saw one for distinguished Toastmaster project description. I don't know if you know this or not. I'm just curious. Does that only come available to the average user on Basecamp when they complete like two paths? Or do you know when it's, how you would access that on the actual pathway system? That's interesting right there.
I'm not sure. I want to hop back to just being a regular user, I think.
Okay.
And see what's available.
It's amazing how different it is when you look at it under Basecamp Manager versus being just, like you said, a regular user.
Mm-hmm.
You really see everything.
And there are tutorials and resources that I think can allow you to see other elements. So there's resource documents in English. And yeah. So yeah, you need to be in as Basecamp Manager to see all of that. Oh wait, project descriptions. Here we go.
Yeah.
And there's so many that you kind of have to scroll to the bottom to force it to load all of them.
Yeah.
But yeah, you can look at the project description for Distinguished Toastmaster. What I did was use this to populate that list for Excel. You know, the VPE pathways for VPE's project. But here's how you get started on your Distinguished Toastmaster project. Oops, I accidentally clicked the email. It tells you you need to contact World Headquarters. One full path and through level 3 of a second different. That's interesting. I did not know that.
That's interesting stuff right there. Look at you. Look, this, you just find gold no matter where you drill down, don't you? Look at that. That's what I wanted to know is how do you make it go live as a link like that or as a selectable option? So that's what I wanted to see. Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, and it's under tutorials and resources. And project descriptions. And this is where you can get a description for any and all projects, whether it's on your pathway or not.
That's good.
Let's see. Tutorials. I think these are super helpful. There's any little, if you were ever wishing for a video clip on how to do something in pathways, this will show you or at least tease you. It talks about completing a project, completing a level, scheduling a speech outside your club. That's one I haven't watched yet. How to save documents to your e-portfolio, you know, and these are all things that any member can access. They just need to go to tutorials and resources and they can get there from the homepage. So as soon as they log in, it's one of the big buttons right here.
But the key is to go to the bottom of the page to make sure all appear, right?
Yeah, right now it's not filtering at all for anything. So you could, so it's showing you Arabic, French, German. You could just keep scrolling forever and find it. Or you could also click some filter links by the kind of thing you're looking for. You can't really change what you sort by. You can choose a more list kind of view as opposed to a thumbnail view, whichever makes it easier for you. And you can also filter by type, right? Class, curriculum, material, or video. What?
Nick, I forgot these are being recorded. Oh my God. Oh, okay. Hello, District 63. Oh, man. Are you the director of the year right here?
You're fine.
You said it was not intentional, okay? So.
Yeah.
I'm going to go, but thank you very much, Nick. Everyone else.
There's a secret little section here of reports, standard reports. You can see there's not all that many standard reports, but this is where you could see outstanding requests. I think, interesting. I think this is something that I should not be here. We're seeing behind the pathways curtain. I think I'm seeing this because I'm as a member, I am Basecamp manager. And it looks like I could share my approval privilege with other members. Because these are members. The users listed above will have approved training access for which of the following users? With whom would you like to share your approving permission? So this is where I could name someone. Maybe not. It may be locked down. Yeah. Let me see if Dunn is one of the people with who's the club president. Yep, looks like it doesn't work. I can check boxes, but it won't do me any good if I can't name one or more delegates. So like what it's saying is if I click this link and I find somebody and make them a delegate, after making them a delegate, I can specify for whom can they approve pathways level progressions. Interesting. There's a little bit behind the curtain there. You can see here where you can access those different areas. If it's hard to remember that you need to click on your profile picture to be able to see your feedback, or click here and there to get to your badges. They're all right here. But these aren't buttons, these are just pictures. If you want to go to your feedback, you have to click on the word "my feedback." Any questions? I feel like I've covered a lot of the little hidden nuggets.
Right. I, for one, have seen a lot of new things tonight. That was some really good stuff, especially with the badges and some of the things that we can do with Basecamp, and just, you know, kind of refamiliarizing myself with some of the resources that we have, including what you're looking at right now with just what you can, printable resources as well as on-demand video type things that we can use as well.
Yeah, this is interesting too. All the little worksheets that they sometimes throw into a project, you can access here, like that time and task log. That's something I think I had to do in leadership development, one of my earlier speeches, but you can just access it here.
Jimmy or Brandon, either of you have any other questions or anything you wanted to cover?
Well, I have something I might ask. At different times, I've wanted to go and get an evaluation resource to send someone else. And what I found was I could pull up the resource, but it would not allow it to be fillable when you sent it to someone. And in other words, it looked like it was restricted to keep people from getting all the resources out of Pathways. It lets you look at it, but again, it's if you try to send them a complete fillable PDF, it doesn't work. Like they restricted that, and it, I saw it change from a different time frame. In other words, at first, it would allow you to do that. Then it looked like they locked it down. And I don't know what it is now because I haven't recently. I'm talking about an evaluation resource for, let's say, a level 4, level 5 project. And you're trying to send an evaluation sheet to somebody else in a meeting so they'll have it. And it doesn't work.
Right. I think that's not, I'm putting some things in the chat. Let's see, downloads. It's particularly that second one, if you wouldn't mind trying to download that and see. When it comes to fillable forms, if you don't have an Adobe license, it can be kind of tricky on sharing those. For the longest time, the only way I knew to save would be to, you know, make my changes. And print, right? And it wouldn't be fillable anymore, but it would at least save, it would print my changes. But I think now both Chrome and Firefox, when you click the download on the fillable form after you've made a change, you can download it with your changes. Get it done.
Tinkering with it right now, and I can type stuff into it. It's pretty cool.
Right. So now, if I go to downloads and open the Get It Done one, it should open in Firefox. And hopefully be fillable still with the information in it. Yeah.
Go to another field and see if it'll let you change it now.
Oops, left off a 0, but it looks like it works.
Yeah, okay.
So there's hope. I think whatever issue you had may not be there anymore.
Okay.
But I'm happy to work with you to, you know, offline.
Find it again if... It's pretty easy to find if you try to send either a project description or an eval form and let it remain fillable.
All right, well, I guess that's it. Any questions about Pathways in general? You know,
Nick, did you cover reports in a previous training for Basecamp managers?
Yes.
Yeah, it does. I don't want to go over that again, but also on the approval of someone's completion of a level in Pathways requires basically two steps. One is done in Pathways through the request, request feature, and then also you have to go to Club Central as well.
Yep.
And you've covered that, I guess.
Yeah, elsewhere. But yes, that's an important point.
Because that might get overlooked. Someone might just do it in Pathways, but forget to submit the award.
Mm-hmm. Approving in Pathways stays in Pathways, and that's when they get their badge. That's when they get a little blue check mark that says they're completed that level. But if you want DCP credit, then you need to still go into Club Central and submit education awards.
Right.
And if you choose the person, it'll list for you. There is some integration because it'll list for you the pathways they've selected and what the next level to submit an education award for them for, right? This is telling me I've yet to submit an education award for either one of Christina's pathways. She may have already done the work. I might have approved it in Pathways, and I might not have come here to say she's completed a level one in persuasive influence. And that's a disservice to my club's progress, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let me go back.
So it's both approving the request for approval when the person completes like a level and then also submitting the award as well for the mm-hmm. DCP, right? That's an important distinction. Right. Glad it's a good thing you brought up.
Yeah, and I'll put the link to my Pathways for VPEs training in the chat. Yeah, that's it. Get shareable link. There you go.
Also, when someone completes it, when you've submitted the award and they get a certificate of completion, how do I access it? If I'm a VPE, for example, or president, how can I access their certificate so that I can bring it up and present it in the club meeting?
I'm thinking. I saw that there's a way to access certificates, but... I want to say that you can't, but I might be wrong there. I want to give it a...
Yeah, I haven't found it myself. I've had to ask the person to send me a copy so I can do a formal presentation that they completed and give them acknowledgement in the club meeting.
Right. Member progress is just going to be reports. Basecamp manager, path progress dashboard, printing certificates. Log in to Pathways and go to that link.
Okay, I'll take a look at the tutorial then.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
I know that that is one thing that's interesting that I've learned with people who are on the printed materials. Like you or the VPE or the Basecamp manager, I should say, has to go into Pathways and click very particular boxes and go in and manually say that they've completed those materials. It's interesting. And there's videos on that as well. All right. Well,
okay. Very good.
Everyone, thank you.
Thank you, Nick.
Hope this was valuable, at least interesting.